Good morning, esteemed guests, faculty, delegates, members of the press, and board members. We are elated to welcome you all this morning here to mark the end of an era and the beginning of another. To this 10th edition of Jaipuria Model United Nations 2022. We shall be your hosts for the morning, and we look forward to your kind regards for the next hour as we share with you this stage that has shaped future leaders, orators, ideators, and yet continues to take leaps forward towards enhancement of character, mind, and spirit. Jaimin is no competition. It's a platform that sustains empathy within us, because even amidst heated debates, we solve problems amicably.
The Jaipuria Model United Nations is a 10-year-old, most treasured brainchild of our school. As we walk into this edition in the hope to uphold the esteemed legacy of this conference, we are sincerely reminded of everything this conference stands for and of everyone who has lived this dream. The first of its kind in Uttar Pradesh started with an easy number of 50 delegates and then transformed itself into the most cherished conference with ever-growing delegate numbers, more dynamic committees, bigger teams, and broader visions. Jaimin has lived through the dark and light of all that has walked its path and ever only hoped to deliver the very best of its abilities. Jaimin has helped us transform from being researchers to rapport builders, to having made a plethora of memories together and to learn skills for a lifetime.
Our hopes, promises, and duties to each one of you stands more empowered than any other time. Ladies and gentlemen, the wait is over and we are back. Once again, we welcome you all to deliberate, defend, and deliver as we present before you Jaipuria Model United Nations 2022. To invoke the blessings of Goddess Saraswati, we humbly invite our chief guest, Honorable Justice Kawaljeet Singh Rakhraji, Principal Ma'am Promni Chopra, Vice Principal Sir Anupam Vidyarthi, Director of Jaipuria Institute of Management, Dr. Kavita Pathak Ma'am, a successful academician who has been the guiding force in shaping the young management students, along with Principal Navsrijan Asha Chadha Ma'am, and all the school heads, along with Shalini Sinha Ma'am, our academic consultant, and our MUN coordinator, Ma'am Preeti Singh, for lighting of the lamp.
Om Agni Mile Purohitam Yagyasya Devam Mitvejam Hutaram Ratnidhatamam.
Lord Ganesh is widely regarded as the removal of obstacles, the patron of the arts and sciences, and the god of intellect and wisdom. To invoke his blessings in making our endeavor a successful one, we present before you the Ganesh Vandana.
Thank you.
students for such a beautiful rendition. I would now like to invite the very backbone of our school, a stellar lady with a lot of poise and serenity, our honorable mentor who has stood behind us and has been the guiding light, who has been instrumental in making Jaemin a reality. Ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together to welcome our respected principal, Ma'am Promni Chopra, to bless us with her words.
Honorable Justice Kamaljeet Rakhraji, my dear delegates, teachers from different schools, the academic consultant, Mrs. Shalini Sinha, Navsrijan Principal, Mrs. Asha Chadda, all my school heads, and the entire Jaemin committee led by Mrs. Preeti Singh so efficiently. A warm welcome to all of you on this bright morning. It makes me very happy because we've had a 1 year skip of Jaemin and then an online Jaemin, which anyway was a great effort. But we are glad that we are meeting here in this auditorium after 2 years. Now, when we are meeting after 2 years and doing such a simulation, we need to understand our objective. Biodiversity loss, climate change, water scarcity, conflict, privatization of water, women problems, child abuse, poverty, overaging population and overpopulation, nuclear weapons. The list is endless. And you all can add a lot to this list. But we have to understand, why is this list increasing when we have a body which is called United Nations? Are we really united? Isn't that a pertinent question to ask? These problems plague the world. I'm sure you'll agree. They are an offshoot of development. But when development is streaked with lust for supremacy, greed, and apathy, it is only then that we add to the problems rather than solutions. Nothing can validate this more than the recent pandemic, which shocked and shut the world. But who found the solution? Perhaps the sensitive souls. And this is what the objective of this conference should be. Whenever we do something, there has to be a larger aim, and obviously a personal goal too. So let's talk of these, and I'll tell you my aspiration for you from this Jaemin this year. There is indeed a solution to the global problems, and it lies here in this conference. When you train yourself and when you get into this simulation and play your role as diplomats, keep the objective of your role very, very simple. To be humane is perhaps the simplest things, because there is no deceit there. Train yourself to be humane while you ponder over issues. Seek inclusive solutions to world issues. Develop an inclusive mindset, because inclusive solutions always spring out of sensitivity. And if we have a world of sensitive human beings, we cannot have these problems. They will not multiply. They will definitely reduce in their power. Now, when we talk of inclusive solutions, then at this point, I would like to request the Jaemin committee to include our Navsrijan children in Jaemin from next year. Let's see you train them. They have as much potential as you have. So let us begin with our own home. In these 3 days, when you deliberate upon issues and affairs in the 8 committees, defend, not to oppose, but to excel. Not to win, but to improve upon yourself. It is not to prove your mental prowess, but again, to develop an inclusive mindset in the larger interest of humanity and follow the precept, which is so very Indian, Vasudev Kutumbakam. Don't you think the world needs this? And if all of you have gathered here for United Nations, this should be the dictum for all of you. And somewhere for United Nations, rather Jaipuria Model United Nations, it should be definitely displayed on the boards. We strive for Vasudev Kutumbakam. Your personal goal, as I said, should be to excel and not compete. Now, this is an opportunity for you to analyze your capability to understand the perspective of others. There may be times in the conference when you will not have very, very valid arguments, or your words may fail you. At this time, what should you do? It's a skill to listen. Develop the skill to listen so that you widen your perspective through the perspective of all those who are around you. People may be better than you. You may feel so. But should that cause embarrassment to you? No. It's essential to know that Google has 167 failed projects in its symmetry. So can't you and I make mistakes and yet be the best? Still, we talk so much about Google. When they can do it, they can wear their failures up the sleeve. Why can't we? We have to train ourselves to walk around with aplomb and not carrying our embarrassments with us. When you walk out on Saturday, nothing should linger in your memory as a regret, because you are here to learn. You are here to become better debaters, prudent solution seekers, and find, most importantly, the you in you, which is much, much beyond marks and grades. They are not your reality. With this, I wish all the delegates of JMUN an enriching, fun-filled 3-day conference, which leaves them with huge memories to cherish forever. Thank you so much, everyone, for your presence.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for being our pillar of support and strength. We, from this platform, ma'am, reiterate your expectations to an unachievable level. Born in the year 1946 at Jhelum, now in West Pakistan, Sir did his schooling from Kanpur and joined law school after graduating in science. Sir was a topper and gold medalist in law from Kanpur University and joined state judicial service in the year 1970. Before elevation as judge of the High Court, Sir served as district and sessions judge in various places like Gonda, Dehradun, Meerut, and Lucknow. Sir also worked as Registrar General of the High Court for some period and as additional LR in Law Department of the UP State. After having served as a judge for 7 years, Sir retired. We now welcome with a huge round of applause our chief guest, Honorable Justice Rakhraji.
Honorable Principal and other faculty members, teachers, delegates, it is my pleasure to associate with 10th chapter of Jaipuria Model United Nations. I am grateful to the school management, particularly the principal and the event coordinator, for providing me this opportunity. It is heartening to note that SET MR Jaipuria School, in addition to conventional mode of education, which focused on preparing the students for securing a good job, a good position in the society, is now also preparing them to meet present day challenges before the society. and globally before the whole mankind. They are imparting value-added education to the students. What is the value-added education? See, in conventional mode of education, we teach the students to language, mathematics, physics, chemistry, all that. It gives them knowledge about the subject. But how to use that knowledge ultimately is the main thing. If you acquire knowledge to use atomic energy, but then if you use it for destructive purposes, then it is of no use. It is rather better not to have that knowledge. Therefore, value-added, value-based knowledge is what is required and what this your institution is imparting. Through debate and discussions, the students are preparing themselves to identify the causes of present problems, their solutions, and steps required to be taken to prevent their recurrences. This journey of the school, which commenced as per information gathered by me in the year 2003 with the participation of just 50 delegates, has shown excellent performance, as today around 500 delegates are here to participate in the event. This by itself is a certificate of success, and the response by the students, their participation shows that the light which the Jaipuria Model United Nations wanted to kindle in the heart of the students, that has worked. A further heartening factor is that this event is fully organized and managed by the students. It is very commendable. This shows their involvement and their effort in reaching the object. Formation of committees and fixing agenda for discussion has very successfully been done. It is appreciable that the school is working in collaboration with Amnesty International, which is international organization for the protection of human rights, and is also in collaboration with United Nations High Commission for Refugees. There are two lighthouses which guide us, which guide and govern us in taking social, economic, and political decisions, and guarantee basic rights. Now, what are those two lighthouses? For the present purpose, one is United Nations and Declaration of Human Rights, and the other is, for our purpose, Indian Constitution. The working of United Nations is done in a democratic manner, decisions taken by majority, but sometimes there is difficulty in implementing those decisions because of the constitution of the Security Council. The Security Council has 7 permanent members which have power to exercise veto. Now, if the decision is taken by the majority for the benefit of the countries, for the benefit of the nations who are the members of the United Nations, and that decision is not in the, that doesn't meet the interest of the countries who have that veto power, they veto it, and the purpose is frustrated. Now, you, as a student entering in this field, preparing yourself for better contribution in the framing of the society, for service of the nation, for leading the world. Now you have to consider what is the solution to this. I would say that it is not always that you get to a right solution, but there may be solutions which are, for the time being, acceptable. And there is always scope to have better solutions. There can also, there are always better suggestions, and we should take the decisions by keeping our mind open. Now, the second lighthouse which guides us as to what is to be done, what social, economic, and political decisions to be taken in the interest of the country, in the interest of the society, is our Constitution, Constitution of India. Now, this Constitution of India, which has been given to the nation by the people of the nation. We, the people of India, have resolved to constitute India into a democratic country, democratic social country. And what is the object to achieve? The object is to achieve, to secure to all of them justice, social, economic, and political justice. When we speak of justice, social, economic, political, then there are so many factors, so many things which are to be taken into consideration, and that is what is required to be learned by the delegates who are now stepping into second phase of their, probably second phase of their life. They will be joining jobs. They are maybe going in different fields of the life, working there. So therefore, what is social justice, social, economic, political? Then the Constitution of India says it secures to its citizens liberty of thought, expression, belief and worship, faith and worship. Now that liberty is there, but still we see, we find, and particularly these times, presently, we find there is a lot of disturbance in the society because of controversy relating to religion, belief, faith and worship. Then the Constitution ensures equality of status and opportunity, and it further says to promote fraternity, assuring dignity and unity, integrity of the nation. Now this is the Constitution which guides us to take appropriate decision, social, economic, political, which may be for the benefit of the society, for the benefit of the nation. Now working and taking decisions for personal interest is not bad. Everybody thinks of himself first, but confining that your activity only to the self-interest is not in the interest of the society or in the interest of the nation. And you cannot live in peace unless the society by and large enjoys peace. Therefore, the decisions are to be taken in life in light of the constitutional provisions. Similarly, from the United Nations, we have Universal Declaration of Human Rights. It is supported with two international covenants, Covenant of Economic, Social and Cultural Rights, and Covenant of Civil and Political Rights. The preamble to the Universal Declaration says that recognition of inherent dignity. Now, recognition of inherent dignity, that indicates that all human beings are equal. You may have acquired more knowledge, more wealth, but dignity is equal. It says recognition of inherent dignity and of the equal and inalienable rights of all members of the human family is the basis of freedom, justice and peace. Freedom, justice and peace are very essential for existence of a civilized society, for development of the nation and for peace in the world. Therefore, recognition of dignity and equal and inalienable rights. Now the what the common man has to do is to make an effort to advance a world in which human beings shall enjoy. We have to make an attempt to make a world in which human beings shall enjoy freedom of speech, belief, and freedom from want and fear. This is very essential. Freedom from want and fear. And what is happening in Sri Lanka? Everybody is seeing what is happening. Therefore, the preamble of the Declaration of Human Rights says, to prevent rebellion against tyranny and oppression, human rights have to be protected by rule of law. The rule of law means equality of person before law, equal protection of law. Rule of law rules out any scope for discrimination. No, the declaration says no discrimination on the basis of race, color, sex, language, religion, political or other oppression, national or social origin, property, birth or other states is to be allowed. No discrimination. Even our Indian constitution also says there cannot be any discrimination on the basis of religion, race, caste, sex. There cannot be any discrimination. Therefore, whatever is to be done for the welfare of the people, it has to be provided to every section, every person of the society who comes within the rule for that distribution. We have to keep in mind that all human beings are born free, equal in dignity and rights. Now this is the equality. We are at present today, we are celebrating 75th year of our independence. It is Amrit Mahotsav. It is called the Amrit Mahotsav. We are the biggest democracy, largest democracy of the world, and we are proud of that. So what is democracy? No, democracy means government of the people, by the people, for the people. Very good. The people of the country elect their representatives in the form of member of parliament or member of legislative assemblies. So we have to keep in mind that they are our representatives. So we can genuinely expect them to represent us properly. But what is happening? What is happening? In the election process, about 30 to 40% of the population does not participate at all. Now there is 50 to 60% who vote. And the votes are divided between different parties and the candidates. Ultimately, the party who gets hardly 20-25% of votes, that forms the government. Now, can it be said that this is a really representative government? No, it is, because we don't have any better alternative to it. At present, this is best. But the delegates, the students, have to discuss and think, what is the solution to this? Can we make a law that it is, we make it legally compulsory for the citizens who are the eligible voters to cast vote? So principally, it may be okay, but it is difficult to enforce. Therefore, what are the other options? Then you, our representatives, go participate in the parliamentary debates and legislative assemblies, but at times we find that they do not participate, at occasions they do not participate freely. They do not actually represent us. They are bound by the whip issued by the party. Now if whip is issued and the representative has to speak and act according to the direction issued to him, where is the independent will of the people which is being, for which he has been sent there to be expressed? So that is lacking. Then there's one thing more. I was seeing the agenda of one of the committee, probably, so they were dealing with the anti-defection laws. So anti-defection is one of the method which has been at present adopted to disqualify a member parliament or legislative assembly who defects. There are some norms prescribed for that. Defection is prohibited. Now, defection is prohibited, that is one thing, but the question remains whether an elected representative has a free will to act and state his views in accordance with the will of the people. So these are the questions you have to consider, whether there is any solution to it. And I would say there are not very many things which can be categorized, defined, classified as right or wrong. There are right or wrong things. But most of the things can be better classified as proper or improper. Now, if you kill a person, hurt a person, it's an offense here. But if you kill an enemy soldier, it is not an offense, you are honored for that. So there are things which are proper and improper. So with that thing in mind, you should always, with open mind, consider and decide if what is appropriate for this particular situation. Now our constitution says there is liberty of expression, belief, faith, and worship. We have liberty. The United Declaration of Human Rights also says like that. But what is happening? What is happening in this society, particularly in our country, what is happening? If you raise a voice of dissent, it is not acceptable. If you question, it is not acceptable. I'm not making any political statement anywhere. But what I'm trying to say is, you should consider what is the proper nature of the freedom of speech and expression. In democracy, unless dissent is allowed, unless criticism is allowed, the activities of the government would go wrong way. Therefore, the dissent and criticism should be welcomed rather than it should be curbed. Similarly, the freedom of religion, there is a lot of disturbance seen every day. Some hate speech has been given, one inter-religion marriage, and there is a lot of trouble created by some persons. So we have to give a thought to this. What is right and what is wrong? To what extent? If the conversion is bad, then it is bad only when there it is by force or by some inducement. Otherwise, where is the freedom? Freedom means if I believe in one religion, and then tomorrow I believe in another religion, there should be freedom for that. So we have to give a thought to what extent this freedom, which is granted to us under the Constitution, is available in reality. Then there are issues and concerns relating to population explosion. We are going to leave behind China in number of our citizens. And there is a global concern about controlling the population. Now everybody should think positive way that it has to be contained, it has to be stopped. Unnecessary controversies being raised. So there should be, we as a student of law or a student of this participating in this German 22, we must apply your mind to these problems. What is right, what is wrong? To what extent there should be interference? To what extent there should not be interference? There are international issues and matters of concern. The refugee problem, we face the refugee problem from persons coming from Bangladesh. Now Russia and Ukraine war is also creating refugee problem. After all, they are human beings. They cannot be left to die of hunger. They also need food, shelter. So therefore, there should be a logical and reasonable solution for this problem. Then there are issues of global warming, pandemic diseases, and then there is accumulation by some countries of weapons of mass destruction. So these are the things which are, these are the issues which are a matter of concern for the globe, for the whole world, for our country, and for every one of us who are living in this planet. So these things we should keep in mind, and I hope that this conference would debate upon the agenda issues with open mind and fruitful discussion would take place. All the participants should give their opinion in the committee meetings without any hesitation, without considering this is right or wrong. What you feel in your heart, yeah, this is correct, you must bring it on record. And it is ultimately then by consensus it is to come what is the resolution of the committee. But even if your view is not accepted ultimately, don't be disheartened. There are cases where one view which is rejected at one point of time is ultimately found to be more suitable and correct view. That is happening in the judicial system also. We give a judgment, then it is sometimes overruled by the Supreme Court, and sometimes the judgment of the Supreme Court, which is given by the multiple number of judges constituting the bench, the majority view is taken at the decision of the bench and it is delivered. The minority view is just placed on the card. After some years, it is realized now the minority view was correct. That is happening. So therefore, it can happen everywhere. You should have freedom of expression. You should have your own views. You should have your own solutions, which you should keep in mind. If it is accepted at that point of time, well and good. If it is not, then you consider, think over, what is different in the majority view, which I should accept or not accept. You have your independent opinion about the things. With these words, I once again thank the school and the management, the principal, the coordinator, and the committee members, the students who have given me this opportunity and invited me here. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir, for sparing your precious time to encourage and enlighten us this morning and to be the chief guest for JAMIN 2022. We now have amongst us our academic consultant, Ma'am Shalini Sinha, and we kindly request her to come on stage and share her views.
Good morning, everyone, and thank you for giving me this opportunity to be here. It's a great pleasure especially because 10 odd years back when I was the vice principal of the school, in came an application from a student called Siddharth, who had applied to be an individual, independent candidate for an MUN session in some other school. So I called him, I said, why are you going alone? Why don't you do as a team? He says, but we don't have a team. And there's no one who can train us. So I just moved in from Delhi, where I was the MUN in charge. It was a great pleasure. So I called a few students who wanted to stay back after school. And we used to stay back in my room. I used to offer samosas, and we used to, you know, gently prepare ourselves. And that was a very small team of not more than 10. And Preeti ma'am became in charge. And I feel so happy to be here to speak on the 10th edition. So really, congratulations to the school. Congratulations to everyone. Preeti ma'am, kudos to you. And why is MUN such an important aspect for me is there is a book called Game of Tennis, where tennis is actually a metaphor. In that I was reading, there is this man, a tennis coach, trying to teach how to play the forehand. He took a student for 15 days, tried to teach her how your body language or your body positioning should be for a good forehand, and he could not. So next what he tried was something different. He got another student to just observe him play for 15 days and did not even tell that student where the positioning of the hand and how the body should be. And he, to his great surprise, realized that the student who had been watching him and then trying it out while playing learned it far, far in a better fashion than the other student. So for me, MUN is actually the epitome of you would be sitting in the parliament. But yes, each one of us would be leading a life which will be full of conflict. And today and for the next 3 days, you learn the art of resolution. And not just the resolution that will be for you, a resolution that is going to help the world. So all the very best, and I invite the divine grace to be in this JAMIN 2022. My blessings. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Sri Aurobindo once said, true knowledge is not attained by thinking. It is what you are, it is what you become. We now welcome our sponsors, CLAT Possible, a well-known coaching institute for common law admission test and joint entrance examination. And we also welcome Mr. Prashant from the Swedes and Universal Booksellers. The blessings showered by God have instilled in each one of us a great robustness to hold this 10th session of JMEN. And as we come here today, having overcome the contretemps of COVID for the past few years, beyond compare is the gratitude that brims our hearts. At this event, we must thank God for giving us the joy of seeing each other, the unity of which has strengthened our preparations.
Team Jaipuria, Model United Nations 2022, has left no stone unturned to provide you with the best possible experience for the next 3 days. The efforts of endless days have compiled to materialize this 10th edition that we celebrate today. I now request our chief guest, Honorable Justice Rakhra Ji, Principal Ma'am Promni Chopra, our academic consultant, Ma'am Shalini Sinha, our director of Jaipuria Institute of Management, Dr. Kavita Pathak, and our MUN coordinator, Ma'am Preeti Singh, to join us for the gavel distribution ceremony of the Secretariat, the Extended Secretariat, and the Executive Board members. We now begin with the gavel distribution for the Core Secretariat, starting with Secretary General Vishvesh Tiwari, Director General Flora Dixit, Director General Sarthak Agarwal, Director General Arnav Jaitley,
Under Secretary General for Delegate Affairs Anshika Suryavansh, Under Secretary General for Public Relations and Outreach Aditya Dixit, Under Secretary General for Administration Akshat Raj, Head of International Press Divya Srivastav. Now we begin with the Extended Secretariat. Under Secretary General for Finance Arjun Singh Rakhra, Co-Head of Logistics Saksham Upadhyay, Creative Head Akriti Anand, Head of Photography and Videography Nachiketa Narayan.
We now call upon the entire Extended Secretariat to come on stage for a group photograph.
Now we begin with the Executive Board. Co-President of United Nations Human Rights Council Anavi Jaitley, Co-Chairperson of United Nations General Assembly Muskan Malhotra, Chairperson of United Nations General Assembly Arnav Jaitley,
Co-Chairperson of Global Democracy Summit Sanya Bhargav, Chairperson of Global Democracy Summit Akshat Raj, Co-President of United Nations Security Council Aruf Baluja, President of United Nations Security Council Vishvesh Tiwari, Chairperson of G7 Advisory Committee on Decentralization Sarthak Agarwal, Co-Chairperson of United States House Committee on Homeland Security Shresh Bindal, Co-Chairperson of United States House Committee on Homeland Security Dhruv Singh, Chairperson of United States House Committee on Homeland Security Aditya Dixit, Co-Speaker of Lok Sabha Utkarsh Srivastav, Speaker of Lok Sabha Krishna Agarwal, Co-Director of Global Press Summit Flora Dixit, Co-Chairperson of G7 Advisory Committee on Decentralization Shubham Chaturvedi. Thank you so much for doing the honours.
Now, let us have a look on the number of schools participating in JMEN. Here at JMEN, we believe in invention, experimentation, and consistently pushing the envelope of growth. As a reflection of those guiding principles, and a small glimpse of the things awaiting you over the next few days of the conference, we are most delighted to present before you the opening spot for the 10th edition of Jeporia Model United Nations. Please appreciate with a big round of applause the efforts of the photography, videography, and tech teams for the same.
Too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous. Everybody circling as vultures. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run, I was born for this.
Whip, whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down. This is not another story. This is not another drill. I refuse to be another number now. Never staying down. This is something real. I'm an
what is wrong? Will they let me sing on TV? Should I keep it light? Is that right? Way up we go. Been up and down that road. Way up, oh no. We gon' burn the whole house down. Watch me standing in line. You're only serving lies. You got something to hide. We gon' burn the whole house down. We gon' burn the whole house down.
Yeah, you used to let it go. Walk into the show. Gawking at the tricks of your sleeve. Too good to be truthful. I'm in a room full of entertainers and thieves. Used to let it go.
Stranger from Twitter is gonna burn this down. first down. Watch me standing in line. You're only serving lies. You got something to hide. We gon' burn the whole house down. We gon' burn the whole house down. We burn it down. We burn it down. We gon' burn the whole house down.
That was a visual treat in true sense. We wish you all the luck and the best of the time here. Before we take your leave as your host, we request you to please give a huge round of applause for the Secretary General of Jaipuria Model United Nations 2022, Vishvesh Tiwari, as we welcome him on the podium. Thank you.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. 3 years. It's been 3 years since we last stepped foot into this auditorium with the purpose that we're here with today. 3 years since Samarth Bhaiya inaugurated the last offline conference, Jaipuria Model United Nations 2019. 3 years since my team and I first saw this dream. The dream that today is unfolding into a very beautiful reality right before our eyes. The last 3 years have perhaps constituted the most eventful times of our lives. We got interviewed for our first executive board positions. We passed class 10th, 11th, and now are in our final year of schooling. The highly anticipated JMON 2020 unfortunately got cancelled due to the pandemic. The pandemic forced upon us a transition from physical spaces to virtual spaces. Even MUNs, where raising placards, passing chits, and crowding during unmods is what makes for a good MUN experience, you know, got shifted to Zoom. Even JMON 2021, the 9th edition, got shifted online. But it still retained the essence of what JMON is all about. Kudos to Sanadi and team for that. This year, we commemorate 10 years of Jaipuria Model United Nations. 10 years ago, under the guidance of Preeti ma'am, students of class 12th hosted the first ever Model UN conference in all of Uttar Pradesh. Through the years, the number of committees has increased, the number of participating schools and so delegates have increased, and Jaipurians' love and enthusiasm for the annual festival that is JMON has increased manifold. As we near the end of an amazing 10 years, I'd like to take a minute to express my gratitude for all those who've made today possible. First, I'd like to thank Justice Kawaljeet Singh Rakhra for gracing the occasion with his presence. Thank you, sir. Principal Ma'am, Ms. Pramini Chopra, and Ma'am Preeti Singh for being our guiding lights and having mentored us well enough to pull off organizing an event of this scale. Thank you to all participating schools and their heads of institutions and their delegates for being here today. Ma, a big thank you to you. Thank you for always being there, and thank you for being here today. To my team, the secretariat, and the entire OC, thank you for standing with me through the past few months. It is because of you that today was possible. Delegates and executive board members, I hope and believe that these 3 days will be an incredibly enriching experience for all of us. Now, by the power vested in me as Secretary General for Jaipuria Model United Nations 2022, I, Vishvesh Tiwari, declare the conference open.